Well, Halloween is just around the corner, and with Halloween, of course, comes a lot of trick-or-treating and all that candy. But all of the candy can really add up as far as calories is concerned. Jen's back with us this morning for some more health tips, and I tell you what, the Halloween candy will stay around for months, and you always find yourself nibbling at it, right?
Oh, yeah. And the thing is, they start putting it out earlier and earlier yep. in the season, so you think back at the end of August, you know, you were buying your Halloween mm-hmm. candy. So that's a little scary. And the thing is, as the days get shorter, you know, we start craving more and more and more. So just to be aware, we're going to kind of do a quick calorie check on a lot of this stuff. And what we've got, actually, is just some candy corns and some of the more traditional candy that we see, and then those peanut butter cups. And just realizing, you know, you can have about four pieces of those for about 320 calories. Doesn't seem so bad, except that a lot of us don't stop at four pieces.
I know.
It's a little challenging when you got that whole bag there, that whole plate. You actually want to go for a little more. Now, the next thing we see is, of course, seasonal lattes. Now, that's one of my favorite things. You get these drinks at these great stores, and they're just delicious, but they can be over 500 calories. And we have a tendency to think a little less about the calories we drink than the calories that we consume. With a spoon or just throwing that in
right.
the mouth. So that's one thing that we kind of want to look out for. Another thing we also tend to overlook is seasonal pies. My dad seems to think that he gets his fruit consumption through, you know, apple pie or
right,
pumpkin pie,
right, it makes
like
sense.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know, that's great. But oftentimes we have a quarter of a chunk of pie, and
right.
it's maybe, you know, 400 calories, and then we throw an extra, you know, a la mode, or your family does the syrup,
oh,
right?
Oh, we do the syrup on
okay.
the pumpkin pie.
Yes.
You just try it once.
Yeah, so I'm definitely
good.
Want to try it, but then, you know,
just once,
gotta realize
though, right?
there's extra calories on there.
Right.
Yeah, all that good stuff. And then, you know, thank God the fair is gone, because I started looking at all the calories that we consume at the fair. 1,080 calories in an elephant ear.
What?
Now, granted, that's about the size of this plate. So, you know, keep in mind that most of us actually can't consume that much in one sitting. We certainly try.
But we do anyway.
Yes, but
yeah.
we certainly do. So 1,080 calories, and usually our entire fat gram consumption for the day. So, you know, we've got a lot of good stuff out there. But one of the things I love about fall is that it's actually a great time for apples.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we start throwing it in our cider and our pies and everything.
Apple cider is the best.
Yes, but there's nothing wrong with just, you know, with just a good old-fashioned apple. I mean, they're really good, and sometimes you can get them for maybe 60 to 100 calories.
Can I cheat and dip it in the caramel sauce?
Absolutely.
They have non-fat, low-fat.
Climb the stairs a couple more times, you know, it adds about 400 calories, but, you know, a little
it all works out, right?
Working all, I'll make it out, yeah.
All right, thanks so much for joining us this morning. You can find out a lot more and ask Jen some questions at our website, WXII12.com. Also at our website, do you want to dress up your pet this Halloween? A lot of cute costumes out there.